Okay guys, so today after quite a long time of testing all three of these audio software solutions for Raspberry Pi, I believe I can give you the best overall summary and in-depth comparison how each of these players stand against each other and which one might be the best solution for you. This video will be quite long and in-depth, so grab a cup of tea or coffee and enjoy. First, I would like to point out that this comparison is based on the latest versions of these players, and yes, there were some updates of each of those. I structured this comparison to chapters so you can skip between the sections you are interested in most, but I suggest you to watch all as there are particular things I discovered about each of these players, which uncovers their particular weaknesses and pluses you definitely want to know and you don't want to miss it. We will have a look on installation time and overall difficulty, the ways of use, streaming services, hardware support, UI design and speed, features, price, sound, community support, and at the end I will do some final conclusion about which of these I believe is the best for your needs and your current situation. First, let me say there is so far no perfect player in this field, and at the end it might be quite a mixed bag of opinions about them, but it all depends on your needs and how you will use them. I will explain everything in detail, so let's go through it. Okay, so when it comes to the installation, I can say all of these players are quite easy to install and use. I have made detailed step-by-step installation and full review videos for each of them, so I recommend you to watch these before you start your own experience with these audio players for Raspberry Pi. From all of these three, I would say a bit more difficult to set it up is Picoreplayer. In a case you will want to use it with Logitech Media Server, repartition your SD card and set Samba, as I did, as Picoreplayer is a bit more complex in that regards. But as there are different options how to use each of these players, for example, if you will use Picoreplayer just as a squeeze light client, already after the first boot up you are ready to go. As with all the other players, you will just need to set the output and that's it. If you would like to use it as mentioned and suggested with Logitech Media Server and set Samba for the possibility to copy your local music files over the network on your SD card, then it requires a bit more time to set it up, but I covered all how to do it in my step-by-step installation guide, so better you watch it first before any frustration in that regards. If you follow my steps, it will be easy and again a question of minutes. Volumio is, I believe, the most user-friendly overall, guiding you at first with the initiate setup wizard after the first boot up. Moode audio player, after it boots up, needs to know your output as all the rest of the players do, and then is also ready to play a stream. Both Moode and Volumio have Samba active and configured, so you can copy files over your network with ease immediately. Moode audio player needs one click of a button to enlarge your SD card using all your free space in that partition. Volumio is already ready for that after the first setup. The ways of use. Now this is one of the most important things which will differentiate and also unite these players quite a bit. Depends what you are interested in. In my example, I have a personal collection of music, which are digital files. And then I also use Tidal as my streaming service every day. Your scenario might differ, but let's say everybody nowadays uses his favorite online streaming service, and I believe most of us also have some small or bigger collection of digital files. So all of these players are capable to play high-res audio files, including DSD files. All players allow you to use for your local library external drive, the actual free space on your SD card, and a NAS drive on your network. All of them have the same capabilities in that regards. Now, each of these players allow you to use them as UPnP or DLNA renderer browser. What that means is that from your UPnP client slash server, which can be running on your computer or as an app on your mobile phone, You can play stream music to these players without them accessing anything else online. Basically, how it works is the UPnP software on your PC or mobile device connects to a source of your choice, which can be again your audio file stored on your PC or mobile device. Or it can be a streaming service, which is supported through your UPnP client. This UPnP client then collects the data and sends them via your network to Raspberry Pi, and it plays it. The advantages and disadvantages of this way of use of these players are these. If you use this way of streaming, you always will need your phone or device you have the UPnP client on in your hands as another main remote control, and you will rarely use the web user interface of these players after the first setup. If you don't mind using it this way, all of these players work fine as a UPnP renderers, but I found there are some bugs and another downsides of this way of use. The UPnP clients, I mean the apps, differ and some support more streaming services, some less. Another difference is how the actual data are sent. I found out that, for example, from Bubble UPnP, I mean the cover art, sometimes show, sometimes the covers don't show. Also, the resolution is very low. On another UPnP client, I mean the cover art worked fine, but I couldn't skip tracks. With Bubble UPnP, I can skip tracks, but also the bitrate limit is 16 bits, 44 kHz for most streaming services. So, most preferable way of use of these players, at least for me, is, as we already mentioned, a playback of local files and then streaming services supported natively with the player. That is the solution I was looking for and prefer. Why is native support of your favorite music streaming service important? Because in that case, the player communicates, for example, with Tidal or Obus directly. So there is no other processing in the path and no need of extra device to select and control your music. Now, how is the integration of that service implemented also matters. As maybe it will have some missing parts, features you use normally, but the integration will not feature it. So, we will focus on supported streaming services in next section. Before that, let me mention also that all of these players, thanks to Raspberry Pi hardware, can play stream music via Bluetooth, and there is also an AirPlay support on each of them. All of these players also support multiplayers, I mean multi-room streaming, and all can be used as a Rune endpoint device. I believe most used music streaming services are currently Tidal, Obus, Deezer, Amazon HD, and Spotify, plus indeed some people like to listen to podcasts and online radios. In regards to online radios, all of these players support huge amount of them, sorted by different criteria and so on, so I believe you will find some of your favorite ones. When it comes to high-res audio streaming services, Volumio and Picoreplayer support Tidal Hi-Fi and Obus natively. Spotify is in some way supported on all of them. Deezer is supported natively only on Picoreplayer. But don't be disappointed that even if you pay for Hi-Fi subscription of Deezer, unfortunately, it will stream only low-res, not high-res stream from Deezer. Big disappointment there, but seems it's more a ball on Deezer's side they have to work on. And seems so far they don't want to help to support it. Unfortunately, Amazon HD is not supported on any of these players yet, and also none of UPnP clients supports them, as I know till now. Hardware support. All of these players are keeping up pretty well with a driver support for majority of Raspberry Pi external hardware, digital transports, DACs, and other from all known brands. Also, if you will be using external USB DAC, I never had a problem with any of these players to recognize them without any driver, as they are all Linux-based distros. When it comes to MQA, currently only Volumio supports MQA if it recognizes attached proper MQA dock. Design UI and speed. When it comes to design of the web user interface of each of these players, as always, it's very subjective, but in my opinion, visually Moode audio with that adaptive background looks the best. Just be aware the adaptive background color works only for locally stored files. Didn't work for me when I was streaming via UPnP, but I believe the previous version I tested worked fine all the time. The boot up time, if it matters to you, is the fastest on Moode audio than on Picoreplayer, and the slowest booting time I experienced with Volumio. A second when it comes to look very close to Moode audio is Picoreplayer with the material skin, which has a lot of customizations, and I personally like it a lot in the dark version. Volumio comes as last, as still even with the adaptation of the new theme called Contemporary, it still needs some proper design tweaks to make it work for me, as a pleasing experience visually, I mean. But from intuitiveness point of view, and the ease of how you navigate through, Volumio is the best. But once you get used to each of these interfaces, they all work very well, so no problem there. Speed-wise, all of those interfaces are very similar. It's based on your internet speed, but overall, when all is cached, all the artworks, everything works fine. Other features. Well, Picoreplayer and also Volumio have quite extensive plugin support, which opens up the possibilities how to use these players, with Picoreplayer being on the top in my opinion. How you will see a use of those depends completely on your needs. Volumio, for example, also includes Amazon Alexa support and can be controlled via Alexa for basic commands. Volumio also now has a feature called Tidal Connect, so can be remotely controlled directly from Tidal app. Picoreplayer includes also a possibility to display lyrics and find some basic artist metadata, which might help you to find out more about your favorite artist. Similar but better looking metadata-based discovery feature offers Volumio in their highest priced plan. Which brings me to the price. Both Moode Audio and Picoreplayer are completely free with all the features mentioned. But Volumio differs. With the free plan, you can use Volumio for streaming of your locally stored files and as a UPnP renderer. But if you want to use native Tidal or Obus integration, you need to pay approximately $3 monthly. Also, with the basic free plan, you can't use Bluetooth. The highest plan, which is almost $7, offers the new feature called Music and Artist Credit Discovery. And you can use it in up to 6 devices, if you are interested in that multi-room player solution. Sound. This is going to be also very subjective and controversial to talk about. So let me first start that I experienced strange issues with UPnP streaming of my Tidal music over Moode audio player. Tested with both UPnP clients I used, the bitrate wasn't equal what the source was. On the other hand, with Volumio, I was pleased with the possibility to truly get maximum of the resolution, as the streaming offered, in other words, the output was equal to the input. Picoreplayer unfortunately doesn't support higher resolution than 16-bit 44 kHz when it comes to Tidal, so it was a slight disappointment there. All local digital files are played from all of these players in a bitrate as they are, so the output equals the input. Sound-wise, overall, when playing and testing on the same file should be all equal, I believe, unless there is some post-processing or EQ cooked in from the developers, as I had that feel on Moode audio last time. But with the current versions, the best sounded to me was Volumio this time, then Moode and Picoreplayer equal. But that is very, very subjective indeed, so don't take me on that. Support overall. Well, I became a member on forums of each of these players to see how people respond to questions, and found out that all players have a good support from the members on the forums, and people always tried to help me with any issue I had. So what is my conclusion? What is the best player from these three? Well, it all depends what you use as your favorite streaming service, what is your hardware, which way of use you prefer. Another question is, are you willing to pay for Volumio? If not, Picoreplayer would be my choice to go with. Volumio in this new version supports Tidal Connect, and the integrative native support now features even the mixes section I was complaining it was missing before. So big pluses to me. But then if you don't like how Volumio looks, again, it's up to you to choose your winner. But it's a tough one, I know. I brought this in-depth comparison to you so you can choose what is the best for you. Thank you for watching. More videos are coming up soon, so don't forget to subscribe, like, and I'll see you next time. Take care.